Fujifilm announced the X100V camera. Really interesting camera. I had the version F, which was nice, but a lot of upgrades. Their promo videos, they had different photographers, and there's one specific photographer that's very into the street photography. One of the photographers that I'm subscribed to on this channel is Samuel. He's into the street photography, and he actually did a video with Tatsuo at one point, and I saw that. Looks like I did not comment on it, but I was familiar with his style of photography, so you can look in those comments to see what people generally think about that style. So with Tatsuo's style, with that general style, it's a mixture of candid plus an aggressive way of going about it. Now, it's not true candid photography. Generally, candid means you are away from it so that the subjects don't know they're being photographed. So I'm not going to go over the legal aspects of all of this. Anyways, that's basically why all of this big issue seemed to happen with the X100V announcement. Just from the short 7-minute video, you can see that he's trying to evoke some type of emotion from them at points, basically trying to get a certain style of photo that he's created over the years. And I understand the point in a way, and I understand his style, but also it creates a lot of negative tension. It creates a lot of issues with how people perceive photography. One of the big questions is about Fujifilm and should they have taken down the video. Personally, don't see any issue with Fujifilm deciding to remove that. It's a business decision. If you look at YouTube and you see all of the adpocalypse issues that have happened throughout the years for YouTube, for advertisers that put their money into the platform, businesses don't want to have a negative relation to their product, to their business, and it just makes sense for them to take it down. Obviously, Tatsuo makes some great work, but are there ways for you to achieve a similar result without being negative towards your subjects? I do think there is, maybe not necessarily the facial expressions and the looks that he gets. A lot of the good points about street photography, one is historic record, showing how society is at a certain point of time. All those things related to street photography, I see some positive cultural benefit. So I don't think generally public photography of other people is a negative or bad thing. In my personal opinion, I think empathy is extremely important. That means basically not making the person feel negative about their experience with you. As photographers, as people that enjoy photography, I think we need to be stewards of this craft, basically showing it in a positive light with people around that aren't interested in it, that they just want to live their everyday lives and not have people putting cameras in their faces. So if we can find a nice balance, think of ways to do that. Think of ways to promote street photography in a positive light. If you try to use the laws as a crutch and say, well, I'm legally allowed to take these photos in public, this and that, this and that, that's not going to help the situation. That's not going to help. And laws aren't in stone. They can be changed. Anyways, Scarf Photography Banzai.